I'm Ilyan St. Hilaire, and in this video, we're going to take a look at customizing the Windows agent icon for MeshCentral. MeshCentral has a unique ability of being very customizable. You can change the look of the website, you can change your policies. But one thing that's very unique about MeshCentral is the ability to customize the agent itself. In fact, MeshCentral can break the agent executable for Windows apart and put new signature timestamp, put new file information in it, and also put a new icon in so that when somebody downloads the agent, you can put your organization's icon on the agent. And this can be done even if the MeshCentral server is running on Linux. So the code to customize the Windows agent is all Node.js and therefore can run on any platform, on Mac, on BSD, on Linux, on Windows. So that's a wonderful thing. Again, a Linux server will break apart a Windows executable, change the icon, reassemble the executable, and sign it and save it for users to use. So that's quite unique. I want to show how to change the icon of the agent, but I'm also going to show a couple of things that you may encounter when you're doing that. And also I want to talk about the properties window on the agent and some of the details there. So let's take a look at that. First, I'm going to switch to my trusty developer server right here. And I have it running there. And of course, it's working and I can remote control into machines and so on. So this is working perfectly fine. Okay. So by default, I'm going to bring my download folder. I am going to download the agent. So add agent, I'm going to download the 64-bit agent. There goes downloads, and here's the default icon. And the default icon is just one bitmap. So if you're familiar with bitmaps, there are icons, there are lots of different bitmaps in different resolution and colors. This one is a single bitmap, so even if you put extra large, you'll see that it's just one. And if you put it small, actually there's a different one right there. But that's it. So the idea is that the default icon for the agent is quite small. It doesn't add to the file size very much. Okay, but I want to go ahead and change this icon to something else. So the first thing I'm going to do is bring up the config.json for my server. And I have a very, very small config.json right now. I am using SQLite, but you can use any database you want. Doesn't matter at all. But down here, I have a section called agent file info. It is in the domain section. And the reason why that's important is you can customize the agent per domain. So you could have 10 different domains for 10 different customers with each one their look and feel, each one their own agent logo and agent information. So I'm going to remove the underscore here so that this section becomes effective. And then you'll notice that I have icon and then a file name of an icon.ico. And then I have a few description and other things here to customize my agent. Now, let's take a look at this file for a moment. This meshserver1.ico, you can put any name you want, but it will be in the MeshCentral data folder. So I'm going to take a look at, I'm going to bring up here the MeshCentral data folder that I have for my server. And you'll notice down there, there's meshserver1.ico. ICO, which is the file here. Again, the file doesn't matter, the file name doesn't matter, as long as this file name matches what you have right there. If you have multiple icons, one for each domain, then just, you know, have all your icons in the MeshCentral data folder, and then, you know, specify the right one for each domain in the config right here. Okay, another thing I want to mention is, and I mentioned this a little bit, .ico files are actually a combination of many bitmaps. And so I'm going to have Visual Studio here. I'm going to drag and drop this icon onto Visual Studio. and this is just to show what's going on with icons. So there's a 4-bit, 32-bit, and so on. So there's a whole bunch of different bitmaps here. And so an ICO file is a combination of lots of different bitmaps, and MeshCentral does support fully taking all the bitmaps inside the ICO file and putting them inside the executable. So all these get imported. And that is a worthy point to note because it is quite complicated to do. It is not as easy as one might think of just taking the ICO file and putting it in the EXE. There is actually two different sections in the EXE, one for icon groups and a separate for each bitmap. And so when you import the icon, you need to split the EXE apart, change the icon group, point all the icons to the correct bitmaps, and import all the bitmaps. So anyway, MeshCentral can do that. So I'm going to put the icon here. You don't have to put all of these other things. If you leave this out, then the default information for the agent will remain. But the nice thing about customizing this is that it really makes your agent quite unique to your server. So that's even better. Okay, so I've set this up. I'm going to save the config.json. And then as soon as I restart the server, you'll notice that the server will check to see if the agent in the signed agent folder is correct. And if it is not correct, it will re-sign it, re-timestamp it. So now you'll see it recreated the new agents and put them here. Now, one thing you'll note is that, wait a minute, the icon that I set look like a, and we can see it in large here, it looked like a tower with a lock on it. So this is like the MeshCentral router icon that I use. So that's the icon, but when it re-signed, you don't see the new icon on these executables. Now, if you try real hard, you may see them sometimes. Like here, if you change the view, sometimes you'll see it there. And the reason is that Windows caches the icons in a icon cache. So Windows Explorer does that. And the problem is when you overwrite these files, the icons, even though they're there, the Windows keeps the icon in the cache and doesn't update the cache. There are tricks online to how to reset the icon cache. I haven't tried those. They seem a little tricky and complex. But just so you know, you may see the wrong icon here. If you right-click and say Properties, this icon here may also be incorrect. So here it happens to be correct. Let's see if the other one is also correct. Yeah, it is. So that's good. But it may not be. So here, if I reset the server again, the server will check these two executables inside the signed agent folder, see that they're correct, they have the right icon, they have the right signature, they have the right information here, and so the agents are not signed again. And of course, just another point I want to make, this information right here is available when you right-click and you say Properties, you go to Details, and you'll see roughly that information being filled in the Detail tabs right there. So you see sample, product name, and so on. Okay, and we'll talk about this a little bit later. Okay, so now I have my icons, my new executables. They have the new icon, but sadly, they may be incorrect here. One way to see if they have the correct icon is you just download them. And the problem is when you download them, it also caches the icon. So if I say add agent, I download it, it downloads there, but see the icon's wrong. So then I'll say add agent, download it again. And this is wrong too, but that's because I've done this before, and so it already cached these files. So I'll try it again, third time, and see, boom, now we have the right icon. So just be warned that even though the agent has the correct icon when it signs it, it may not show up depending on what your icon cache looks like. And that applies to the MeshCentral data signed agent folder. It applies when you download the agent. So kind of fact of life. But trust me, if you put a correct icon, .ico file, and you change it, the agent real executable will have the right icon. Okay, so that's one thing. The other thing I want to do is I just want to show one more quick thing, and that is these product information. So these strings are a little tricky also. And to demonstrate this, I am going to take this executable. So this is mesh agent. I'm just going to call it mesh agent.exe. Oh, there, you know, by renaming it, the icon just popped up. Nice. But so that may be a trick for you. So anyway, I'm going to put this agent that I downloaded, I'm going to put it inside my temp folder. And I have I am going to use Authenticode.js, which is the node tool. So node/Authenticode.js- and then I'm going to do in. So this is, by the way, a tool that I have for basically taking a look at an executable, signing it, and timestamping it. And I recently added things to save bitmaps, to save icons, to show icons into the latest version. But you'll notice one thing that's interesting. When you change the properties, the resource properties of an executable, there is a file version with a value, but there's also a file version number with n as a set of numbers. Same for product. There's a product version with a value, which is a string, and then there's a product version number, n. So the reason I want to highlight this is because if you take a look at an executable, so for example, pull my mesh agent 64 here, if I go in properties and go into details, the file version is actually the number n here, but the product version is actually the string, not the number. So this is kind of weird. I'm not sure exactly why they did that. But these other things, these strings here for the file description, product name, copyright, the original file name, those are actually the strings. And you can see the original file name, the file description here, and so on. So you can change those. But for product version, it's a string. And for the file version, it's the number here. And so if you look at info, exe, see. So I'm going to basically run information, just collect the information on the exe that I just downloaded. Now what this tool does is it shows you the file, the version information in numbers, and the version, the strings. And so you can see product version here and has a string, and that's zero for the numbered version of the product version. But the file version has a string and a numbered version. So anyway, the reason I want to mention that is because some people have been looking at the older version and they're like, wait a minute, the file version doesn't change. It doesn't match what I put in my config.json. So I put a version number of something and it wouldn't show up here. And so that has been fixed. As long as the file version is four numbers separated by three dots, then the latest version of MeshCentral will set that string and we'll decompose it, decode those four digits, those four numbers, and put it as the number here. So this is why in the later version of MeshCentral, the file version now works. Now the product version is even more interesting. It's showing the string, but it shows the string as long as the string contains at least one alphabetical character. So if I just put 0123, it doesn't matter what the numbers are, but if I just put numbers and dots, and now I stop it, like restart the server, it's going to resign the my server. So I'm going to go back into my data folder here and signed agent. I'm going to right click on my my agent, and you'll see the product version is empty. But I put this, you know, the string here, but for some reason it's empty. But if I put any character, like the letter A at the end, and then I run it again, as long as there's at least one character in this product version, then when I right click and say properties and look at details, there you go, the product version just popped up. So super bizarre. And I played around with putting the product version as numeric, as a number, as a string. I tried different things, but the only thing that's consistently I can see is that as long as if there's no alphanumeric, if there's no alphabetic characters, at least a letter from A to Z, from lowercase or uppercase, if there's not that in the string, then the string just is empty. So don't know what's going on there, but you know, put a V in front of that that product version string, or you can put a version like that, and that's okay. And so as long as you do this, it will sign the agent again, and then as soon as it's signed, I can right click, say properties, details, and you'll see, oh, actually no, here it didn't work. It's product version, the version didn't work. But if I put just a V here, I think that will work. So I guess I haven't figured out exactly when does this show up and when it doesn't. But let's try this with a V in front. I'm pretty sure that will work. And yeah, that works. There's a V in front here, and you see the string. So yeah, a little bit of a mystery as to why that is. In any case, so this was a demonstration on how to change the icon on your Mesh agent for Windows, how the icon file, all the bitmaps in the icon file will be imported into the executable. The cache on the Windows Explorer, you know, icons will cause it to be a bit of an issue. And also the file version, use 4 digits with 3 dots. For the product versions, you may have to put a V in front in order for it to show up. Hopefully that was helpful. Just lots of mysteries here. If by any chance you solved one of these mysteries and you know the solution to why the product version doesn't always show in a string, or if you have a super easy way of clearing the Windows Explorer icon cache, like something like super, super simple, I would love to hear that in the comments. Thank you very much. Have a great day.